Now, so many people love curry, so this is going to be a really beautiful, wholesome beetroot curry. Now, it all starts with this gorgeousness. Look at that deep red colour, full of beautiful antioxidants. It's got that lovely, earthy taste. Right, if you could thinly slice that one. Now, it has some beautiful coconut oil here. Now, you can use olive oil as well, but it's nice to change it up sometimes. So, I've got some coconut oil. Just plop that in a pan, a good tablespoon. Okay, so what we're going to do is just plop some of this onion in there, and we're going to sauté this down just for about 4 to 5 minutes, very, very slowly, making sure we get that kind of oniony taste out there. Mike playing the ginger and the garlic there. Now, I have some curry leaves in here that I'm going to put in here as well.
I'm just microplaning it down to my fingers, making sure I don't catch my fingers.
Your bare knuckles.
Because it wouldn't be a vegetarian dish if I got any of my finger in there, would it? There we go.
So what we'll do is we'll stick all of that goodness. We've got that ginger, that garlic. So we've got antibacterial, antifungal, anti-everything in there. Okay. In we go with this one. Nothing better than that smell. So if you could just pass me those lentils there. So beautiful red lentils. You can use yellow, green, whatever. Just stick about half a cup in that one. Have one tin of chickpeas in there. So this is where I'm getting that lovely plant-based protein, okay? From your lentils, your poor man's meat, okay? And those lovely chickpeas as well. Gorgeous legume. So what I want you to do now is just pass me some of those spices. Now, you'll see I haven't got chili, okay? So chili can sometimes be the thing that causes the rumblings. So what I wanna do is I have some cumin to give it that lovely, lovely smell. Have some ground coriander as well. And I just have some garam masala as well in there. It's fabulous. Now, if you could just pass me the turmeric.
There we go.
So I want to have about a really heaped teaspoon in there. And that's going to give it a beautiful colour, but also it's also got all those nutritional properties of the anti-inflammatory, which is what we want. Now, I have 400 ml of vegetable broth, but you could use chicken broth, beef broth if you want to, but I am trying to make this a lovely vegetarian curry here. And of course, we need to just plop some of this lovely beetroot in there. Now, beetroot is quite hard. If you ate it raw, you'd be chewing for quite a while. Now, what that means is that needs quite a bit of time in the pan. So if you just pass me some of that pepper as well, just gonna add a bit of salt just for seasoning and the pepper. That smells great. Now, we are a bit slapdash. We like to cook kind of fast sometimes, but if you want to really keep your eye on the measurement, then we have this level marker right in the pan, really convenient. So all that's left to do now is stick on the lid, which, by the way, we can just hang it out there as well. So you know sometimes you get condensation, you've cleaned the bench top already? No longer, it can just hang out there. So we'll stick that lid on. Now that needs about an hour, okay? Really get that beetroot nice and soft. So we'll let that one simmer down on a lower heat. We'll go have a cup of tea, then we'll come back, finish it off. Now that's been cooking for about half an hour, and I'm just gonna add a bit of coconut cream, Richo, just to give it a nice bit
of lusciousness.
Extra lusciousness. It's gonna make it a little bit creamy as well. Just mix that in. Back on, the lid goes. We can have another cup of tea.
Love another cup of tea.
That is smelling divine, isn't it? Really, really good. Now, I just heated a roti on this lovely nonstick pan, and I added a little bit of coconut oil, but with a good nonstick, you actually don't need any oil whatsoever. The great thing as well is there is a bit of a thermo spot there that tells you exactly when it's ready, when it goes solid red, time to start cooking. So I think the only thing left to do now is have a bit of a taste.
It looks good. It's thickened up beautifully. I love the coconut in there. You've used a lot of coconut. It's a real, almost like a Pacific sort of flavour to it, isn't it? Tropical flavour.
It is, where you can smell that. So you want to make sure that you don't get those curry leaves. I actually kind of like it when I do. I feel special when I get one of those ones. Now, some of that red has leached into the sauce, and that's absolutely fine. That's just what happens when you cook beetroot.
The goodness has gone from the beetroot into the gravy.
Hasn't gone anywhere, and it's going to end up in your mouth, which is all that we really care about, isn't it? So, got some little bits of roti there, and I've got some coconut yogurt as well, just so that we can keep this vegan. So, I'm going to stick a little bit of this just on the middle there, like that.
You had to ruin it for me, the vegan stuff.
There I've got some coconut flakes as well, which just add a little bit of... Well, it just makes it look really pretty, doesn't it? Amongst a bit more of taste.
It does.
And you can put a little squeeze of lemon on there as well.
Put lime on there as well.
Lime as well.
Yeah, great.
So I've got some brown rice. It's just a bit lower GI than normal white rice, so I do tend to choose that one. Now, I really want to get some of this sauce and have a good taste.
And I will say that the colour really has bleached out. It almost looks like a sweet potato or a carrot, you know, a little bit sort of red in there, but it does look good, and I'm hoping it's cooked all the way through.
Yeah, of course it's cooked all the way through. Mm. Now, the great thing about this is it's a way of getting veggies in your diet without you noticing too much, but...
But that is a cracking dish. Even though it's vegan, I still like it.